What is the crack, ladies and gentlemen? It's Gibboeire here with another episode of World of Warcraft on the Kronos 2 server. Hey, y'all doing? Okay, so no more fucking PvP. I'm done with that for a couple of days. that was an absolute overload of it, and I need to go back to doing some monotonous questing.
Yay!
Okay, so the last time, which wasn't the 100 subscribers video, the last time we were playing, we had attempted to do Nomragan, and of course me, in my infinite capacity to be brilliant at this carry-on, turned off the recording at some point during it and totally shit the bed. Right, so I'm going to try and get another run through Nomragan if I can. Nomragan? Like, I'm only reading it. I always call it Nomragan. Now I'm looking at it, it says Nomragan, so I don't know. Pronunciation. Anyway, that doesn't matter. I'm going to try and get another run-through of it, so that way, because I like to do the big, long episode where we do a run-through of the dungeons, because I think you guys like that shit, too. I don't know if I should hand in the quests, because I won't remember them, really, then, would I? Data Rescue, the Prismatic Punch card. I think last time I kind of explained how a lot of them are done. I think I can remember most... No, that was a ring we found. Okay. I can remember most of what they are. So while we're going through the... Yeah. While we are going through the instance, I will... Shoni, she's in the Dwarven District. While we are going through the instance, I will give a run through of where you do the things. That's going to be the best bet. Things I need to do, though, however, before we go anywhere. I have no poisons, no nothing, no anything left. Because I used it all in the making of that video. And when I mean I used it all, I had this full of poison. And every single one of them got used. I think I had a stack of 20 of them. I think I had a stack of 10 crippling or 5 crippling. No, yeah. I'd say about to here was full of poison. All of those. And then I had a full stack or two of that as well. And I had a few other bits and bobs that have just been totally consumed. And I've now got nothing left. I got lots of loot, though, from that number again. I'm like, I can't believe I didn't record that. That's frustrating. The things that go wrong. Now, hang on. Somebody left a comment saying that you can filter it to... so it only shows the available spells. Thank you for that.
A good one.
Because that's fucked me a few times now. So it's nice to have that out of the way. What else? There was a couple of other... I remember getting so many useful tips in the past couple of days there now. It's unreal. I can't remember them all right now. I will actually go back through it. That's worth stuff because of the what you call them? Twinks. Twinkie Doodles. Right. What do we need? We need to make poison. Right. Okay, so I'm going to make a... How many have I got? I make 15 of these, so that's 15 death weed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 15! No, I fucked up. Shit. Right, hang on. Shift. 2. Go. Away. Lovely. Perfect. It never happened. Leaded vial. By 3. Now, what do I need for this? Stack of 20. I'm going to want 60 and 60. 120 for 2 stacks? Back in a minute. I figured out that I can shift click and type and not click. That's good. That's good. Okay, so we are making 10 crippling poison. I'm going to make 40 instant poison too, and I will make 15 deadly poison. I'll probably make a few more of those. Yeah. So look, you can just type, and there we go. Boom. That's handy. 2, 3, 4. Lovely stuff. So I won't show this. Jesus, we just spent like a gold on poison. I'm going to make all this shit into useful stuff that we can have, and then, oh, don't forget the flash powder. That would suck. Right, what do we want? I want a stack of 19. Keep making things. This is going to take so fucking long. I'm going to get a... We'll go for a second stack of that as well. This is really chewing into the inventory space. The endless predicament of teching up, getting better shit, but yet requiring to carry more items, thus requiring more inventory space, to hold more loot, to tech up, to require more items, to carry more inventory... Ah, fuck it. Stressful. Stressful. Right, so we have that done. What does that leave us with? We've got 20 each of these, 10 of those from when we want to act a dick, and then we've got a lot of flash powder for when stuff goes wrong. So, that's all good. That's all good. We are going to make our way to Ironforge after going towards the Dwarven District to hand in our quest. So, I will be back in several seconds! Yeah. Right. You may notice a few seconds there. I'm trying to remember my hotkeys to fucking record. So, if I was kind of like making a bit of a type of face, that you understand why. Anyway, Shoni. Shilent. What's crack, Shibai. Starry. Shitty Mitch, there's too much shish going on here now. I get both or one? I get one. I could sell that for more.
Off and away.
By sell, I mean I can vend her. P.S. Just in case anyone is confused, is what I mean. Right, we're going to go into Deep Run Tram, and we are going to make our way. I have no idea what that is. Our way over to Ironforge. Bye. Talk with a draw accent. There's a part of Ireland, I think I've gone into this before about accents and stuff like that, how there's different types of sounding accents in such a small area that is my country. In Dublin, which is the county I'm from, there's just the main, it's where the capital is and all that shit, and I think it's got a population of something like 1.2 million people, which, you know, on an island of 4 to 5 million people, it's quite a lot. You've got a massive variety in accents. But the typical two stereotypical Dublin accents you get, of course, the one that I'm using, which is a north side Dublin accent, which has kind of accent, kind of nasal sounds and stuff like that. You'll hear a lot of sound kind of coming through on top of me nose, bud. And we say our D's as T's and stuff like that. Then you've also got the south side Dublin accent, which Roish people would talk like this, like, you know. Which is kind of like the stereotype then being that north side dubs are scumbags and that south side dubs are posh twats. Which is, you know, totally true. So anyway, another kind of accent that you get, which is not too far from here now, if you head north a wee bit and you go into County Louth, there's a place called Drada, and the only way I can ever really get myself into this accent is if I say a certain word, because I have a colleague of mine, and he is from Drada, and there is a bar of chocolate you can get from Cadbury's called a Star... I have to say it normally first, a Star Bar, and it is basically a Morrow bar with peanuts in it, and it's really tasty chocolate, by the way, but that's besides the point. the only way I could ever do this guy's accent is if I say it the way he says it, a Star Bar, go to the shop there and I shall get a bit of a Star Bar, and they talk like that, and it's fucking gibberish, like, I swear to Christ, it's worse than a Cork accent, which is another place. Another county in Ireland is Cork, which has an absolutely insane accent, but the Drada accent is just one that I cannot fucking wrap my bleeding head around. It is absolutely insane. I don't know, I reckon there's probably YouTube videos of people from Drada talking, like, it's that fucking mental, that, like, it probably has its own little kind of sect of thing that people have recorded it. I don't know how I got talking about Drada accents, but there you go, Staba. Anyway. Here we are, and we'll hand these quests in. So what my plan is, anyway, is I am going to
interesting.
Do another run-through with Nomragan, hopefully today. And what I will do is, as I come across the various different quest items and stuff like that, I will point them out. So that way, I know I'm not like doing a dungeon guide or anything like that, but it's more so for that you guys know how I got the... Ooh, there that. Wow, that's a lot of agility. I wish I had those when I made the fucking PvP video. That would have helped, like, a significant amount. Christ, right. Yeah, that's a massive improvement on what we got. Shit, deadly.
Greetings.
Yeah, bro. Give me that. Oh, we get bow. Oh, well, sweet. Right, vendoring the shit out of all of that. This is paying for all the poisons that we used in the previous couple of episodes. I'm quite happy about this.
Can I help you?
No, but you're probably going to anyway. Now, we found a ring while we were in there. Oh, my nose is still stuffy. Jesus fucking Christ. If anyone was wondering if I made, like, weird sounds when I was recording the first bit of that special video, my nose is like, it feels like it's going like that at the moment, and I'm snots, the whole lot of fucking boogers coming out of my nose. It's shit. It's really shitty. I think this guy is in here. The ring thing. I have a very vague recollection that this jerk is in here. Well, they have quests, so we'll go in here and we'll have a chitty chat with them anyway. These might be Alderman quests, if I'm not mistaken.
How are you?
No.
What's on your mind?
Is that in...
Be good.
Scarlet Monastery? No way! Oh, shit. Well, fucking deadly. That's It's nice to have that. Right, this ring quest is, it is definitely somewhere here in fucking... TDK. It's somewhere in Ironforge. I fucking remember. Oh, and it's like, it's in a little nook like that. So what we'll do is we'll actually head this way. And I'm going to do a lap of the place. And I will be back in a moment once I find this jerk. So, hold on a minute! Oh, Jesus, that was quick. I literally ran for about 20 seconds and then this popped up. So here he is. Talvesh del Kissel. Del Kissel. Or whatever his name is. You're handing this quest in probably too. How are you, bud? I found your ring. Watch the crack. What? The partner important bit. I don't know. Before now, But I can make you a better one. That design, like I said, is really simple. And the brilliant gold ring, a silver bar, a moss, I got it. 30 silver coins. So I need to get a bar of silver. Now. I'll do it for the crack and the quest experience, which I'm sure there's none. Right, we'll go for it. I need to find an auction house and get myself a silver bar, so... How did I think about it? Just hear me out here for a minute. I'm gonna drop some physics in on this shit. I know nothing about physics. Just disclaimer. Right. Lava. Yeah? Magma. Whatever the fuck you might call it. Magma's below the thing. Lava's when it comes up above. Whatever. Is this magma because we're under a cave? Ooh, questions. Anyway. Lava. Molten metal. All that shit there. And the fucking the bellows. The whole lot. And all the anvil and all that shit. Enclosed space. Yeah. And that. Heat? Like, temperatures in here would be fucking astronomically high? Surely this is a totally inconceivable and totally unsafe construction. Like, somebody should get onto, I don't know, the Health and Safety Authority to have a look at this place. Because this isn't sound construction. Like, that's a cowboy builder job right there. Right? Yeah. Okay, so it's looking like... 17 silver is pretty much as good as it's going to get. Oh, well, 18, really. You jerk, you do what I do. And then we're also looking for a moss agate. 16, that seems okay to me. I've had a few of these over the course of our trip around Azeroth, but sure, hey-ho. What can you do? Right, lovely stuff. I'll go grab them, and I'll make my way back to this jerk, and we'll see what the crack is and what he's got us to do with the thing and the thing. Well, so I totally just looked at what we get. For doing this quest, and I regret this immensely. Whatever, the experience is gonna make us ding. That's what I'm reckoning. Yeah, just take my money. And we got no experience. Fucking hell! Really. That hurts my soul. No, I want to keep that one on. You want to get rid of that one because then we can have more stamina. Anyway, the spirit ain't really... It's going to help with recovery in between combat and stuff like that. But other than that, it's not really much use. We've got a fair bit of shit we can vendor there too. So it ain't all bad. What's RFD? That's Razor Fen Downs. That's the hard one, isn't it? Shit, I don't know. Right, so we need to kind of go quest somewhere now, don't we? That's our next job. So I reckon I may well fly to... Where is near to here? Probably going to be Menethil. We'll fly to Menethil and we'll just see what the levels are like for the quests. Because I think we're pretty close to that. If not, I will make my way back down to Stranglethorn and just go with what I know. I guess it'd probably be the best bet. I hate these fucking cloth... Quartermasters, you're fucking dicks. You always think you've got a quest, and then this dick is like, oh, I just want to take 60 million clot off you, you fucking jerk. Oh, thanks, bro. Thanks. Okay, yeah, now we're going to make our way up here. Up here. There doesn't seem to be any groups going for Nomragan or anything like that. So we're just going to quest instead, and then I'll just keep my eye out for it, and then if it does happen... Like, who gave me an intellect buff, by the way? When did that happen?
What can I do?
But, 27 to fly over here. Fucking how expensive? Like, Jesus. Can you not get like a pass card as a member of the Alliance whereby they just let you fly around for fucking free? Oh yeah, it was called flying training. It costs a bazillion. Okay, we're here. I've done a quick cursory kind of look around to see if there's like anyone that like has a low level quest, and I've been like hovering my cursor over people to kind of see what the deal was. Doesn't seem to be that many really floating around. We've got first mate here who he wants me to buy him a flagon of mead. I've already taken the liberty of doing so. So let's have a chitty chat with this chap about his fleet. We got 200 experience. Enter the ruins of Altric. Wait, no, that's oh, Jesus. I thought he was telling me to go there as well. Cursed crew, kill.
See you later.
Kill a load of lads. It's yellow. No shit. No, these are good. This is fine. And then the green warden is another one. That, and I actually know where he is because we've walked by him at some point. That, however, is grey as shit. Well, fuck. Right. Let's see if there's anything else. If not, we'll just head off and do that quest. And then I may have to leave this area. Because, yeah, she's going to try and give me a quest. And it's going to be shit as well. Bugger. Right. No, we might be too high for this. Yeah, we are definitely too high for this. Oh, that sucks. We could do the elite quests. It'd be another thing that we could do. So I am going to go to do this quest now. Because why not? Depending on where do I have to go? You can... Yeah, no. That's not happening. The cursed crew. Where is it? Wrecked off the coast to the north. Okay, so there to the north. North. Head north. There was another... I thought I saw a quest. No, I didn't. I'm blind. Whatever, it's fine. It doesn't really matter. I don't think we're going to be staying here, really. After my brief kind of glance around, I've... Is that a clicky one? No, it's not. After a brief glance around, I've definitely come to realize that this is definitely a too low of an area. Like, he would have probably given us a quest.
Well met.
Yeah. Rough. No, we're too high of a level, which, you know, that's a good thing because we're doing so good. No, we'll do this quest, and then I will probably make my way somewhere else. You know what? If I don't see this fleet right here... Oh, there it is there. That's actually still a fair bit of a trek. I was about to say I'm not doing this. No, we will do it. And then if I see a group going for those elite quests, I'll do those as well. Because I think I remember a dagger gets dropped from one of those. And we need a new weapon, so... But we will make our way over yonder. And we will see if we can find the boats. So I shall be back momentarily. Probably going to be South Shore then, I reckon, is where we're going to end up going. More PvP! No, not a hope. Yeah, South Shore, I'd say, because I think this is like the Red Ridge for the dwarves, if you get my kind of thing I'm doing there, the dynamic I'm trying to draw between the two of them. Comparison, not dynamic. But I think this is like Red Ridge for dwarf landy place. Dwarf landy place. It's a thing, look it up. It's an actual term used to apply to shut the fuck up. Right, so I hope this is the fleet. The cursed third fleet. No, please, no. It is the Lost Fleet. Excellent. And the Cursed Marines are... Oh, they are quite a high level, actually. Shit. There's Snellig. I think he was just chasing someone. I'm not sure what happened there. But anyway, yeah, here's Snellig. So I'm going to whack on a couple of poisons. Again, I'm not sure if I'm putting these on the most efficiently kind of... You know what I mean. Not sure if that's hippa happening, but whatever, we will figure it out. Oh man, no, he looked like he was dropping some serious beats there. Right, anyway, let's go get this guy. Oh, now you swim. He is swimming like a fucking thing that swims fast. What? Right, here, let's see how fucking chunky these are anyway. What's the crack on killing them like? I don't think they'll be that bad. Come on, let's go. Time to join us, Rogue. Who's Rogue you? Huh? Who's that guy? Yeah? Sounds really fucking cool. That's what he sounds like.
I can't do this.
Oh man. Somebody was also telling me to use key bindings. I've never used key bindings. Now, before we get into that and being like, oh, why don't you use key bindings? Because I'm a lazy piece of shit. And I've always just done it this way. But when I hit 60, I will put key bindings on. And I will... No, actually, that's a lie. I did learn how to use key bindings on my druid, actually, when I was healing with raids and shit like that. Key bindings were cool for that. But we've nearly leveled. I'm not going to level up that way. What the fuck is this shit? A pan of damage dealt, resistant casting speed. But we look so fucking cool. Look at me. I'm an undead rogue. Oh man. I should have been on the horde. That was a mistake. Or was it? Who knows? Who knows? You won't. A couple of people were asking about the shaman in the past couple of videos. So, to get into what's happening with that. Kronos 1 doesn't have the same population that it had a couple of weeks, months ago rather, when Kronos 2 started. Where the fuck do we put this now? See, this is tricky. See, the improved kick could be good, and so could that extra bit of dodge. And I don't really use gouge enough, but I might use it more if I have a better one. That'd be good for killing rogues, so we're gonna put that into that.
I need to target something first.
I'll target you now in a minute. But anyway, yeah, it doesn't really have the Oh shit, I forgot to be in stealth. Oh, we've pulled a few of them. Ah, that's fine, because, we're super awesome and amazing! So we'll do this really, really fast. Quick, do the damage. Because it's not getting the same population traffic as it would use, I reckon it probably wouldn't be as much fun for me to play on it. And I don't think as many people would be interested in watching the older server as they would be the new one. I don't know, I do actually miss playing on it. There's been a few days now that I've been like logged on and looked at it and been like, I want to use this. But, I don't know, if there isn't going to be a draw for it, like, it kind of makes it hard to encourage myself to want to play on it. I don't know, I might try and have a bash at it later, and I'll see how I feel about it. If I'm enjoying it, then I'll probably record an episode for it, and see where it goes from there. And if it gets the views, then, fucking sweet, why not? But, I don't know. Again, I'd like to stress that I'm playing the rogue a lot, because I'm enjoying playing the rogue. Look at the little side shuffle thing that they do. Hey! Right. Kill this. Get shanked, motherfucker! I had a lot of fun making that 100k video, I have to admit. I get it was pretty haggard in terms of the quality of the sound effects. The sound effect. Alright, let's fucking be honest here, there's one. But learning how to put that into the video, that was a big deal for me, man. I was really chuffed with my fucking self. I was well impressed with myself. That was a serious kind of like, I gave myself a pat on the back. I was like, I'm fucking, I am the shiznick. I got this shit, brah. No, I was really happy with it. I was chuffed. That was cool. Here's Hoder. Or whoever. Oh, man. That's something I've never actually watched. I've read the books for Game of Thrones, or at least the ones that were out at the time. Did he kill Schnellig? Schnellig! Fuck. Schnellig! Schnellig! Got to have a bowl of Schnellig fruit and fibre. I'm undead. Why am I losing breath, eh? Eh? Oh, well, they do too, it's just slower. Oh, motherfucker! That's something I noticed as well, I was recording that video. I said motherfucker so many fucking times. Holy shit. That was a lot. Not enough. What was I talking about there a few seconds? Oh jeez, I hate it when that happens. When you just lose your train of thought. I get so easily distracted. Anyway. I remember I was talking about something to do with fucking sound effects or that. Yeah, I had a really lot of fun doing all of that. So I'm looking forward to making other videos. This isn't an announcement. But I'll talk about it now. And, just so as a heads up for anyone that might be interested. I'm after downloading Armor 3. I know Armor 3 isn't new or anything like that. But I was playing it earlier on because, Steam sale. And a friend of mine who is fucking hilarious commented on it and then started messaging me, having a chat with me about it, saying, you want to hop on later and play a few games of it with me? This guy is fucking hilarious. I went to fucking school with him. And I think I may have discussed this before about when we were playing that first person shooter kind of Counter-Strike-y anime game that was on the free for a while. It was really funny. This guy is fucking hilarious. So I reckon we do a bit of co-op or PvP and that. I'm not really sure how it works. I know there's like lots of mods for it and shit, and like DayZ and all was on Armor 2. And I know there's a DayZ standalone now, but I'm uncertain. I actually probably will get that while the sale is on the go, because that's the type of game that I would enjoy. But anyway, where was I going with this? He's going to hop on it with me later. And I think this DLC, the Apexus mod or something, is coming out soon. But you could pre-purchase it, but I think it's opening in the next day or two. And I have 2 days off. So I'm going to play it with him. And like, if it's funny and I get a good buzz off it, I'll probably record it. And I reckon it'll be a good giggle for you folks as well. It'll definitely be interesting. And like, depending on what way that footage goes, I may edit that footage up, like, kind of like, do a kind of, you know, Frankie on PC kind of 1080p thing. I love his fucking videos, and I think that's a bit of an inspiration for what I'd be doing on it. Now, I don't think I'd ever get anything near as good quality as the way he does it. Like, the way he fucking does his movies, they're actually like mini TV shows, you know what I mean? Like, they're like mini kind of like TV series episodes. Like, it's so fucking cool. Wait, was it shift right click was the auto do? Ah, okay, that's cool. I don't want a mana potion though. Oh, here, you dick.
I can't do that yet.
Quickly! Drink it! Can't use that item because you're a cock. Right, we'll get rid of that. Jesus, there's so much guild recruitment going on. It's really cool to see all the guild recruitment and all that stuff again. I know, like, it still happens in WoW and all that shit, but I know the. Did he get held back, or am I tripping balls? Anyway, it's cool to see all that shit. You know when they first brought out all that shit for the guilds with the, like, the guild experience and all that? Now you have a mana potion? Everyone's got a fucking mana potion. I don't want mana potions. I want potatoes. No. All you racists and your stereotypes about Irish potatoes and all that shit. I remember playing Call of Duty, and like, if a Yank came on or like that, do you know what I mean? Apologies to all the American viewers, but that's what we call ye over here, a Yank. And I know that a Yank to an American is a Yankee, which is, I forget what part of America that is, but I had this conversation with an American person because we were calling them Yanks, and he says, I'm not a Yank. A Yank is this type of person. And we were like, oh, no way. But when we were playing with American people and shit like that in Call of Duty, and, you know, the lads at all start playing, slagging each other and all that shite, and that's everything, every single insult was always potato, potato, potato. Fuck it, really. Like, let's make fun of the famine that killed, you know, 1/4 of the population of the country, and fucking led to the other 1/4 emigrating. Why not? But without getting into that, do I play Perry? Like, that's the only insult that people tend to use when they're slagging Irish people. It's just, oh, potato, 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 ta 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 ta, and that's what they say. You're sitting there, you're going, I actually don't know anyone that fucking sounds like that in this country. But I do like potatoes, so I guess they've got me there, so fuck. But, stereotypes in video games, that's always so funny. Hang on, we kill this shit. I can't remember what I used to say to America, but we used to have fucking shit. Oh, what we would do, because like, we were so mature, we would put on, like, a really bad American accent. Like, oh my god, man, like, what the fuck? And we'd start talking like that, and then that would just lead to copious amounts of insults going between the two groups. And it was always fun. Oh, here's first mate. Schnick, nick. Schnick, nirk. I may be pronouncing his name wrong. There's loads of cursed sailors down here. We need these anyway, so let's start hacking these up. Oh, that was good times. It was good times. Hope I haven't offended any of the American viewers there by making a very bad impersonation of your guys' accents. Oh, man. You guys have a significant amount of accents in your country as well. Although that could be due to the diversity of the population as well. But when you look at somebody that's... What's the name of the Stephen King one? Oh, Fargo. And the accent of those... is that Minnesota? That accent is really funny. And then you look at New York and stuff. You look at the likes of, like, yeah, like, capital cities and the diversity of the accent that's in those places, too. That's kind of what, like, Dublin is like. This guy just doing the drop thing here is insane. And it's getting me really giddy and excited. Oh, man, this episode, I've just rambled about absolute shite. I haven't really woken up yet. I had a bagel for breakfast because I felt like being a lazy dick and not really making real food. And I had a cup of tea, and that was pretty much it. Oh, shit! Speaking of American shit, So I don't disguise this. I fucking love Twinkies. Let's get this set in stone. I am fucking fascinated by Twinkies. And it all started with me watching Die Hard, and the first one fucking, and like the guy goes in and he buys a fucking Sergeant Powell, and or Officer Powell, or whatever he was at the time, and he buys like a bazillion fucking Twinkies, and the guy starts taking the piss out. I was like, what the fuck is a Twinkie? And then I see in Zombieland, and the guy is obsessed with fucking Twinkies. I was like, what's the deal with the fucking Twinkies? I was going out with an American chick, and before I was going out with her, we were fucking chatting and stuff like that. We were friends. Long story. But anyway, when she was over in America, she actually sent me a box of Twinkies, and that was when I first experienced a fucking Twinkie. Oh god, stuffy nose. I had this fucking Twinkie, and it was possibly one of the nicest things I've ever eaten. You can get them in Ireland, they do bring them across the pond, but they sell them in certain, or they sold them in certain shops for the past couple of years. Specialist candy stores, like there was kind of like, in Ireland we've got these like retro candy stores at the moment, that they're like a big fad for the past 2-3 years, and basically they're quite literally exactly what it says in the tin. They sell old candy that you can't really get anymore, but they would stock Twinkies, and they'd sell them at like €3 a Twinkie, which is about what, like $3-4, probably about $3.75, maybe $4, depending on what the exchange rate is at the time. I wouldn't be 100% certain, but fucking extortionate. Because I was told you could get like a box of Twinkies for like fucking $5 or something like that over in America. Not even. Do you know what I mean? Like they're basically fucking zero in cost because they have the nutritional value of a brick. But recently in Ireland, they've started actually stocking them in Tesco, which is, you know, a big fucking chain store. And you can get a box of 10 for fucking €10, which is awesome. It's still extortionate, but it's €1 a Twinkie, which, you know what, in the grand scheme of things, I can fucking live with that, because they taste so fucking good. And another American food item that I am very, very fond of, and again, this is, it's so fucking healthy. Here's this dick. Closer. Wait, is there someone here? Oh, here, wait, whoa, invite. I'd accept the invite, but you're not gonna get the fucking quest credit. Okay, well, tough titties. Anyway, what was I talking about there? Why the fuck? I would assume he was. Oh, you're grinding. Ah, no worries. Well, I tried. But anyway, the quest credit, or not the quest credit, the other food item that I'm very, very fond of that is woefully bad for me is Kraft mac and cheese. And I remember them telling me all about this, and it was just pasta and fucking cheese. I remember hearing about this going, oh, what the fuck? Like, it's just pasta and cheese. It's like a cheesy paste sauce stuff that they just pour all over this pasta. And I'm looking at them as they were explaining this shit to me, and I was like, this actually sounds like the nastiest shit ever. So anyway, it was purchased for me, and I fucking tried it. It was made for me, and it was actually unreal. It was one of the nicest things I've ever fucking eaten. So fucking bad for you. Again, has the nutritional content of cardboard, but is really fucking tasty. And you know, like, if you come in after, like, a shitty day at work, or fucking you're dying of a hangover, and you know what I mean? You have to eat the bad food to fix yourself. So fucking, that's the bad food that I would eat to fix myself. You can get this shit for, like, I think about €4 box over here. Did I use up all my poisons, or did I just never put one on? I used up all the poison already. Holy shit. What have we got? Instant poison still? But anyway, you can get it for about €4 a box here. Sometimes if you're lucky, you can get about maybe for 3. Neither here nor there. That's pretty much that. So they would be the American foods I'm super fond of. I went interrailing a couple of years ago. I went traveling around Europe and that for a few months, which was fucking great crack, by the way, and I would highly recommend it to everyone to do it. Even if you're currently living in Europe, because, you know, Europe is currently undergoing a bit of upheaval, and, you know, who knows how long Europe is going to be a thing. Oh, listen, lads, I'm done with my quest, so why don't you all just go and fuck yourselves. There we go. Out of here. Yeah, I went interrailing around Europe, and when I was in Berlin, fucking went to, first of all, I went to some Mexican place, and I got, like, the nicest lemonade I've ever, minty lemonade, homemade shit that was made there on the day, and it was so fucking good, and a burrito, because, you know, Mexican food is life. But anyway, the next day, I was aiming for a bit more traditional German cuisine, so me and my friend went and found a kind of, like, a kind of family restaurant, a German, like, we walked for a fair bit to get off the beaten track, and found this place, and we went in and I ordered some fucking sausage thing, or I do not know what the fuck it was. My friend was American and she ordered it was basically, when we asked what it was, the waitress explained it as mac and cheese. And it pretty much was. It wasn't macaroni pasta. It was like penne pasta. Penne? Penne pasta, I think you pronounce it. Fuck it. Who cares? I'm sure penne pasta makers do. But anyway, it was covered in cheese, but not the cheese sauce that you would get in like a Kraft mac and cheese box. It was quite literally like melted like mozzarella or parmesan and cheddar. I wouldn't know what fucking cheeses were in it, but there was lots of fucking cheese and butter, and like, it was basically just this fucking melted mass of cheese and pasta, and it was fucking unreal. It was like one of the tastiest things ever. I shit you not, I ate my fucking meal and I ordered a plate of this shit then. So I had fucking two main courses. I didn't fucking care. Like, tight on money, who gives a shit? Fucking Interrail and you're trying to save every penny. Not a fucking hope. I had to have a plate of this shit. And it was the tastiest heart attack I've ever eaten in my whole fucking life. Absolutely unbelievable. Absolutely unbelievable. So fucking good. Let's get this quest handed in.
Hey there.
Right. You know what, I may well not do this quest because I'm only going to get 1800. I'm probably going to leave this quest area because it's not ideal for me, and we've kind of wasted a bit of time when we've come here. So what I reckon I'm going to do is it's probably going to be either here or South Shore, and then I think that brings us up into the Altric Mountain slash the Hinterland, so it's probably going to be South Shore and I'll start questing from there. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to make my way back to Stormwind is what I'll do. Prior to me leaving and make my way up here.
What can I do for you?
And that'll bring me to Darkshire, but that'll be it. No, will it really? Cheaper? No, it's not. It'll still be $2.97. Okay. We'll fly to Stormwind's up. I'm going to make my way to Stormwind, and I'm going to AFK for a bit. Not really AFK, but I'm going to stop recording, and I'm going to hope to... Is that a unicorn on sale? It was a unicorn! But anyway, I'm going to AFK for a bit. I'm going to try and get a group of Nomragon so we can get that knocked in the head. Maybe we'll get a bit of loot as well, you never know. And try and get that episode recorded. And I'll probably do a bit of research myself offline and actually try and figure out exactly where I should go to quest. Just to be a bit more efficient about this. Because I don't want to waste too much time dicking around in episodes, you know what I mean? Like, I'd like progress to be made in every episode and us to actually get shit done. Look at the fucking plane crash there. I wonder if that links in with a quest or a storyline there somewhere, or if it's just visually appealing. It looks cool either way. Anyway, this has been Gibboeire, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for watching this video. I rambled a lot in this video, so I'll get a bit more coherent in the next one, and hopefully you'll enjoy it more. If you enjoyed this video, please consider leaving a like down below, and possibly consider subscribing to the channel. If you've got any questions, comments, or concerns about anything you see in this video, leave them down below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Like, why is this guy holding an axe and a hammer? Or why the fuck did they build this massive fucking unsafe fucking hazard of a fucking city in a volcano? Who knows? I might answer your question, you never really know. Take her, Andy. Bye-bye!